Welcome back, everybody. Listen, we know that staying active can be pretty darn difficult these days, especially if you don't have the equipment or you don't have the space for something like a home gym. But that's why we are going to bring in fitness instructor extraordinaire, Nadia Cordick. She's going to show us a full body workout with stuff that we've just got around the house. Great to see you, Nadia.
Great to see you too. Thanks for having me.
Nadia, it's so good of you to join us today. And as Mel said, every aspect of our lives has changed, including exercise. So how can we be successful when working out from home, if that is what we're choosing to do?
Okay, so the great thing is that some of the best workouts actually don't need to be done in a gym. You can do them at home, as we're going to show you today. And you don't need a lot of equipment. You can use your own body weight, or you can use a lot of objects that we have in our houses. So they can be just as effective as anything we'd be doing at a gym.
Okay, so let's talk about safety, because that's a big one if you don't have a proper setup and you're just stealing a corner in your house. So what do we need to know to stay as safe as possible?
Right, that's a great question. So first things first, listening to your body is paramount. So hands down, you want to make sure you do that. If you're experiencing any pain or discomfort, you want to make sure that you take the time to recover appropriately. You want to really stay focused. I know there can be a lot of distractions at home with our families and whatnot. So in order to minimize those distractions, you want to find a dedicated spot in your house where you do your exercises.
You are going to show us a full body workout today. So what are the specific items we need in order to hit all these moves?
Okay, so for today, we're gonna use a laundry basket. We're gonna use a couple of dish towels or pot holders. We're gonna use a cutting board. If you don't have a cutting board, you can use a tray, that's sufficient. We're gonna use a regular size bath towel and a broom.
Okay, I love this. Okay, you're gonna start off with something that you call a push-up slide. So
yes.
For these, we're going to hang back and watch. I'm already scared. What does this look like?
So for this exercise, it's a take on the traditional push-up. It's a little bit more, actually, I'm lying. It's a lot more difficult than traditional push-ups. So you're going to put your hands on your pot holders. You want to make sure that you have a slippery surface, so maybe hardwood flooring or ceramic. You're going to go into your push-up position. Like I said, your hands are on top of those pot holders. You're going to slide your right hand out as you lower your body down to the ground and hold for as long as you can, which probably won't be that long. Slide that right arm back in and then repeat on the left side. And if you have to drop your knees, then of course you can drop your knees. But if you want to ramp it up a little bit, you'll keep your knees off the ground.
All right. So up next is lat pulls. What do we need in order to make this happen?
Okay. One of my favorite exercises. So you'll need that regular size bath towel. You're going to stretch that bath towel out, hold it on either side with your right and your left hand. You're going to lie flat down on your stomach, and you're going to mimic that lat pull down that we traditionally will do in a gym by sliding the towel close towards your chest as you raise your chest off the ground. And then slide it right back out, kind of like a Superman style. And when you slide it back, if you want to add another level of difficulty, you can bring your feet off the ground as you slide the towel towards your chest again. And that just targets your lower back a little bit more.
My lower back is actually sometimes pretty stiff from sitting a lot during the day. So
for sure,
will it release that tension that I've been feeling?
Absolutely, it will. It will help to release the tension and strengthen it at the same time.
Okay, so the next one, because we're doing full body and you just said core, so you have got a twist on the traditional sit-up, and this time you're using a cutting board, or I think you said potentially even a tray. So take us through this, and why a tray?
The tray is just like to add, just for fun, just add a level of difficulty. And I'm sure pretty much most people can find a tray or board in their houses. So you're going to lie all the way down on the ground with your hands or your arms outstretched over your head, holding the tray in hand. And then you're going to come up to almost a seated position. So with the tray overhead, you want to make sure that you don't come completely to the top, because you want to make sure that you keep some tension on your abdominal wall. Hold for a second or two and then come back down, lie all the way back on the ground, and then repeat that exercise again. So the difficulty, another element of difficulty in this exercise, is making sure that you keep your heels rooted down into the ground, because you're kind of working against gravity and your feet will want to lift up. So anchoring them down is also a level of difficulty and really important in this exercise as well.
Okay, it's time for us to get busy, because Lainey and I are going to do the next several exercises along with you. And we're going to start with the back row. So what household item do we need for this exercise?
Okay, so for our back row, I'm just going to stand back here and grab it. We're going to need our laundry basket. And to add a level of difficulty, you want to make sure that you throw some stuff in the basket just to add some weight. you are going to hinge your upper body over your lower body, bend into your knees, really important not to lock your knees at all, bend into your knees, and then you're gonna bring the laundry basket up to about chest height, squeeze your shoulder blades at the top, and then bring it down, and then bring it up again, squeeze to the top, and then bring it down one more time, bring it up and hold, hold, squeeze, and release it down. And there your back row is.
And we can use the laundry basket for another exercise, right?
The front raise. So next up, you're going to still holding that basket. Still, if you want to add more weight, you can, or take out weight, you can do that too. You're going to bring the basket up to shoulder height, hold for a beat or two, and then bring it down to your thighs, shoulders down and back, bring it back up and hold, always hold to just sort of add that level of difficulty. Bring it down one more time, bring it up and hold.
That's not
squeeze,
a hold, Lainey.
And then bring it out.
You're such a snitch, even in quarantine.
I'm not snitching, it's on TV. Okay, so from here, we're going to move on to the next exercise. And this is what you call a towel lunge tension pull. So what do we need for this?
Yeah. Okay, so we need that towel. It's one of my favorite exercises. If you like resistance bands when you're at the gym, then you'll like this exercise because the towel is going to mimic what you would do with resistance band. So you're going to step on that towel with, let's say, for the side, your right side, and you're going to hold it really taut with your hands. Step your left leg back, and you're just going to lunge down and bring your knee, your left knee down to the ground to tap it. So you go through that full range of motion and then come on up. And so you shouldn't be able to extend fully if you're pulling that towel really tight, because you want to make sure, come on down with that knee. You want to make sure that you're working your upper body simultaneously as we work the lower body. And then come on down and then come on up and hold. And you should feel it even when you're coming down, which would normally be a rest. It should be a workout for your arms as well.
Listen, I love me a good squat, and you've got an overhead squat. What do we need for this?
For this, you'll need a broom. So it's going to mimic how you would use a traditional weighted bar at your gym. So a lot of people make the mistake of putting the bar, or in this case, the broom, on their neck. You want to make sure that you roll that back and put it closer to your shoulder blades. Really, really important so you don't experience neck pain later on. You're going to separate your feet, and we're going to do an inner thigh squat. So you want to make sure you have your feet turned outwards, and you're going to come down nice and low and just hold for like a beat or two. And then come on up, but don't lock your knees at the top, and then squeeze your glutes and then repeat that. And if you want to add a level of difficulty, then you can raise your broom or your Swiffer mop up top overhead and then bring it down as you come down. And that's
Got
the movement.
It.
There you go. Perfect, guys.
This is good.
Yes.
That's the most action Lainey's broom's ever seen. With her.
From me. Nadia, thanks so much for all of this. It's been so fun catching up with you. And to hear some of these tips and tricks on how we can work out from home, they will be uploaded on our website after the show. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.